Good morning and welcome to Grace for Today. It's so good to have you with us. The days are ticking along rightly and we are seeing this week go past so quickly. But of course, it's important to take some time today to fix our eyes on the one who gives us life and can sustain us through these difficult times. The topic for today is His light shines in the darkness. And I'm just going to look at this verse. We should know it. When Jesus spoke again to the people, he said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but they will have the light of life." And that's from John chapter 8 and it's verse 12. Let's just take a moment before we look at this today and imagine just how differently our lives would look every single day if it were in total darkness. Let's think of all the times we've needed our phone torch to see, the times where we've had to light a candle when the electricity's gone off, and also the frustration that we feel when we hit the light switch but we realise the bulb needs replaced. Without light, we struggle to simply see where we're going, we're unable to find things that we need, and we might not actually always be able to protect ourselves from danger or hazardous situations that are in front of us. But more than that, we actually miss the beauty of the world around us that God has created. I imagine that a life in total darkness would feel more like survival mode, and it's not going to be a life where we find fulfillment, where we can excel, or where we can thrive. Another thing about darkness is fear can rise in darkness, isolation can peak, and uncertainty is at the forefront of our minds. And when we experience loss of direction, loss of purpose, and even loss of motivation to continue, things can just be far too difficult for us. This is a very similar picture to the difference that knowing the person of Jesus in our lives will have. This Jesus, who promises what we will have the light of life if we simply follow him, he seeks to actually give us days that are filled with life every single day. And the verse today shows us that. The word light used is phos, as Andrew's mentioned in this series, and it literally means the manifestation of God's self-existent life, whilst also making reference to the divine illumination that reveals and imparts life to us. Here we can see, if we go back to the origin of this word, we can see evidently that light is simply all about life. So how do we walk in this life that has been revealed and imparted to us? We can be hope-filled people, assured of the fact that we are righteous because of Jesus and his sacrifice on the cross. We can know today afresh that God's promises never fail us. His plans are to prosper us as we walk in a life that is filled with light, and he also wants to give us future. We can have a peace that is supernatural each and every day as we walk in this light that comes only from a life with Jesus, as we've seen in this verse. So let's take heart today. Let's look afresh and recognize exactly who Jesus is in our lives. He's the one who brings light. He's the one who brings life to us. And even in those days that are so dark and difficult, and in the hardest of moments, we can be encouraged today and know that we have a light in our lives that has overcome the power of darkness. We think then of another verse in John 1 verse 5, and it says, "The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not overcome it." The light of life in the person of Jesus Christ in our lives, it's superior, it's all powerful, and it's victorious today, church. So let's remember that we have this light in our life. We can choose to walk on this journey with Jesus, and he promises us that our days will be filled with life. And we can remember who Jesus is in our lives by taking communion as we always do as a church. We take the bread today and know it represents the body of Jesus that was broken on that cross. But the broken body was the thing that enabled us to have this life of righteousness, this light-filled life. So we say thank you for the sacrifice, Jesus, that in your darkest of moments, it was a step in the path for us to experience light, wholeness, healing, and fullness because of what you've done. So thank you for your body today. And we take the juice. We know this represents the blood of Jesus on that dark day that was poured out on the cross. And we say thank you, Jesus, that your sacrifice has made us whole, it's made us complete, it's made us righteous, and it's made us hope-filled people who can walk in the light that a relationship with you brings. And that's the end of Grace for Today. It's been so good to join with you. We hope you have a good day and be encouraged.